लाइक से फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर मे बी अ केस, लाइक से फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई व्हाट आई डिड हियर इज आफ्टर एंटरिंग द पासवर्ड आई क्लिक्ड ऑन साइन इन बटन एंड आई वॉन्ट टू डू ए ऑपरेशन ऑन अ वेब एलिमेंट इन द नेक्स्ट पेज. ओके, बट वेन दिस लाइन ऑफ कोड इज बिंग गेटिंग एग्जीक्यूटेड दैट पर्टिकुलर वेब एलिमेंट इज नॉट लोडेड इन द वेब पेज. सो वट विल हैपन, दिस पर्टिकुलर लाइन ऑफ कोड विल नॉट फाइंड दैट पर्टिकुलर वेब एलिमेंट एंड एक्सेप्शन विल बी थ्रोन आउट,
यस सर,
राइट,
यस सर,
बिकॉज इट डिडंट फाइंड दैट पर्टिकुलर वेब एलिमेंट. सो वट हियर वट हैपेंड इज द एप्लीकेशन स्पीड इज ग्रेटर दैन द कोड स्पीड. गॉट माई
सॉरी सर,
पॉइंट? हियर माई एप्लीकेशन स्पीड इज ग्रेटर दैन द कोड एग्जीक्यूशन स्पीड, दैट्स वाई इट्स गेटिंग फेल्ड.
यस सर,
सो वट विल बी माई आइडियल सिनेरियो? माई आइडियल सिनेरियो विल बी दैट केस इन विच माई एप्लीकेशन स्पीड इक्वल्स टू द कोड स्पीड, बट दिस इज प्रैक्टिकली नॉट पॉसिबल टू अचीव. वी आर नॉट दैट एक्यूरेट दैट वी कैन अचीव दैट सिनेरियो इन विच द कोड स्पीड इज इक्विवेलेंट टू एप्लीकेशन स्पीड. सो वट वी कैन डू इज वी कैन मेक आवर कोड स्पीड ग्रेटर दैन एप्लीकेशन स्पीड सो दैट आवर स्क्रिप्ट विल नॉट फेल.
ओके,
गॉट माई पॉइंट?
यस सर,
सो दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस इज नोन एज सिंक्रोनाइजेशन, कोड सिंक्रोनाइजेशन.
ओके,
ओके, सो वट वी हैव टू एंश्योर, वी हैव टू एंश्योर दैट द एप्लीकेशन स्पीड शुड ऑलमोस्ट मैच विद द कोड स्पीड, बट विच इज नॉट प्रैक्टिकली पॉसिबल इन जनरल इन नॉर्मल और इन जनरल सिनेरियो. व्हाट हैपेंस इज वी मेक आवर कोड स्पीड ग्रेटर देन एप्लीकेशन स्पीड.
सर ग्रेटर देन और लेस देन सर बेसिकली, बिकॉज इफ एप्लीकेशन स्पीड विल बी
हाँ सॉरी
स्लो.
सॉरी, कोड स्पीड इज लेस देन एप्लीकेशन स्पीड.
यस सर,
वी इन जनरल केस वी मेक आवर कोड स्पीड लेस देन एप्लीकेशन स्पीड सो दैट इट डजेंट फेल एंड इट गेट सिंक्रोनाइज्ड इन अ राइट मैनर टू एग्जीक्यूट ऑल द लाइन्स ऑफ कोड व्हिच वी वांट टू एग्जीक्यूट.
ओके सर,
इफ द एप्लीकेशन स्पीड एक्सीड्स द कोड एग्जीक्यूशन स्पीड देन व्हाट विल हैपन? आवर
then
कोड
it
विल
will application will get failed and is to exception
आवर
error.
को आवर कोड विल गेट फेल. ओके, बिकॉज वो द कोड इज गेटिंग एग्जीक्यूटेड बट इट इज नॉट फाइंडिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर वेब एलिमेंट इन द एप्लीकेशन, देन आवर कोड विल फेल.
यस
सो
सर,
वट इज हियर हैपन, द कोड स्पीड इज ग्रेटर देन एप्लीकेशन स्पीड. सो वी हैव टू मेक कोड स्पीड इज इक्विवेलेंट टू एप्लीकेशन स्पीड व्हिच इज नॉट प्रैक्टिकली पॉसिबल. सो वी आर मेकिंग आवर कोड स्पीड लेस देन एप्लीकेशन स्पीड. ओके,
यस सर,
सो फॉर दैट वी विल बी यूजिंग वेट स्टेटमेंट. ओके,
ओके,
सो फॉर दैट वील बी यूजिंग वेट स्टेटमेंट. सो देयर इज नाउ कम्स वेट स्टेटमेंट.
ओके,
सो इन वेट स्टेटमेंट वी हैव नॉर्मल वेट दैट वी हैव यूज हियर ऑलरेडी थ्रेड डॉट स्लिप. सो वट दिस पर्टिकुलर वेट इज डूइंग, दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज यू कैन से इज हार्ड वेट और
we are adding some
नॉर्मल.
weight required.
दिस वी कैन से इज द नॉर्मल वेट और हार्ड वेट. सो वट फंक्शन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर वेट इज दैट इफ वी हैव गिवेन इट टू वेट फॉर 2 सेकेंड, लाइक 2000 इज 2 सेकेंड बिकॉज इट इज एंटर्ड एज मिली सेकेंड. सो 2000 मिली सेकेंड इज इक्वल टू 2 सेकेंड. सो वट इट हैपन्स हियर इज दैट इट मैंडेटरली वेट फॉर 2 सेकेंड
Okay, sir.
इवन राइट मीन्स वी हैव गिवेन इट टू वेट फॉर 2 सेकेंड मीन इट विल वेट फॉर 2 सेकेंड. सो दिस इज यू कैन क्लियरली स्टैटिक वेट, लाइक वट यू हैव गिवेन इट विल वर्क अकॉर्डिंगली. बट इन रियल सिनेरियो लेट से फॉर एग्जाम्पल माई वेब एलिमेंट गेट्स लोडेड इन 1 सेकेंड, माई एक्स्ट्रा 1 सेकेंड फॉर हुई इट इज वेटिंग इज गेटिंग वेस्टेड आउट.
यस सर,
सो फॉर दैट विल बी यूजिंग डायनामिक वेट
ओके
इंस्टेड ऑफ
सर,
दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टैटिक वेट बिकॉज इट इज कंज्यूमिंग माई टाइम हुई इज लाइक गेटिंग वेस्टेड.
यस सर,
ओके, सो वट इज डायनामिक वेट? सो डायनामिक वेट वी हैव एक्सप्लिसिट वेट, इम्प्लिसिट वेट, पेज लोड टाइम आउट वेट. सो दिस ऑल आर आवर डायनामिक
वेट
वेट. So what here it will happen in dynamic wait is, like if a particular web element for which we have assigned the wait, if it has get loaded in 1 second, if we have given wait time as 2 seconds, it will stop in 1 second. It will not wait for that extra 1 second. So as a result, my extra time will not get wasted after the web element gets loaded.
Okay.
Got my point?
Exactly, repeat this point, sir.
See,
what dynamic wait.
In dynamic wait, what the thing is happening, like this is static wait or normal wait. So I have given it for 2 seconds, means it will wait for the whole 2 seconds. Okay. But in dynamic wait, if I have given 2 seconds and my particular wave element for which I have applied the wait gets loaded in 1 second, then the wait will stop its function in that 1 second only. The extra 1 second which is getting wasted here in normal wait, it will not get wasted there. Because here, even if it gets loaded in 1 second, it is waiting for 2 seconds. But there, even if I give 2 seconds and the web element gets loaded in 1 second, that one extra 1 second will not be wasted. So it will stop at execution suddenly after 1 second, the web element is loaded. So there I saved what? More 1 second which is not required to wait. Got my point?
Yes.
Okay. Getting the point, right, Tuhina?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt, ask me immediately. So let's see. The first wait which we will be using is implicit wait. So there are three type of dynamic wait. One is explicit wait, one is implicit wait, and another is page load timeout wait. So what is implicit wait? Let's say, for example, while I write Mercury and sign it, a new page gets loaded. This is a new page for me. The previous one was login page. This is the home page. So my home page is getting loaded. So implicit wait for the whole page to get loaded. Once a new page is getting loaded, we will be using implicit wait. Okay, sir. So where I have to use implicit wait, tell me. Just after a new page is getting loaded. So where here my new page will get loaded? For me, the new page is getting loaded once I open the URL. Once this is the first time my new page got loaded. The second time my new page got loaded is when I clicked on login. So I have to apply implicit wait once here. Please stop your mic. See, so what here in implicit wait happen is, I told it to wait for 20 seconds. So this will be second or millisecond or nanosecond, that will be decided by the second parameter which we are passing. Like here I am passing time unit dot second. So by default it will become 20 seconds. But if I would have passed time unit dot millisecond, then it would have 20 milliseconds. But in normal wait or this thread or slip, this is by default what, millisecond. So if I pass 2000, it will be coming 2 seconds. But here I have the choice to say pass it as a second or a millisecond or nanosecond. So that will be decided by the second argument which I am passing. If I pass time unit dot second, then the first argument will be 20 second. If I pass time unit dot millisecond, then it will be 20 millisecond. If I pass time unit dot nanosecond, it will be 20 nanosecond. So it depends on us what unit of time I want to pass. If I want to pass second, I can pass second. If I want to pass nanosecond, I can pass nanosecond. Or if I want to pass millisecond, I can pass millisecond. Okay. So this particular implicit weight will be used immediately once before the page is loaded. So once I hit the URL, my page is getting loaded, I use this implicit weight. Similarly, once I log in, a new page will get loaded. Here also I will be using this particular implicit weight. So okay. Here what will happen, like I have given the time limit as 20 seconds, right? I have defined it ki within 20 seconds my page will getting loaded. If my page didn't got load in 20 seconds and it got loaded in 21 seconds, then my script will fail because it passed the time limit. If I would have given 200 seconds, then if it get loaded in 20 second or 21 second up to 200 second, then my script will pass because I have given it in time limit that up to this time you wait. But if say for example I have given 20 second and my page got loaded in 10 second, then that extra 10 second will not be wasted. Once my page got loaded in 10 second, it will come immediately to the next line of code to get executed. So here what it is happening, like my extra time which is left after my page is loaded or the web element is loaded, it is not getting wasted. It is just skipped out and my next line of code gets executed. So here in dynamic weight, what I am doing is I am saving the time dynamically depending on the loading of that particular page or web element. Got my point? So benefit of dynamic weight you got over this normal threaded slip weight?
Yes, sir.
So I am using implicit weight immediately before a page is getting loaded. So here my page would get loaded, I used it. Here also after login dot click, a new page will get loaded, I use the implicit weight. Okay. Now comes explicit weight. What is explicit weight and why we'll be using it? Like say for example, you must have noticed in certain web pages there are certain web elements which like takes some extra time to get loaded due to the it's a heavy web element or some any feature like DB connectivity or for any reason that particular web element get extra time to get loaded. Even if the whole page is loaded, that particular web element takes some extra time to get loaded. So to here in implicit weight, we are dealing with the whole web page, but to deal with a particular web element, let's say for example it is an AJAX web element which changes dynamically, which appears sometime, which may not appear sometime. So to deal with a particular web element, we'll be using explicit weight. So we used implicit weight for dealing with the whole web page, but to deal with a particular web element, we'll be using explicit weight. Let's say, for example, this password field is getting loaded after some time, or it is an AJAX application. So we have to wait for this particular web element. So what we have to do is, See, here what I did is I waited for a particular web element, that is the password field. I wait means applied explicit wait for a particular web element. Right, explicit wait is used for a certain particular web element. So what is the syntax? I create an object of web driver wait and pass driver instance with the time. Here by default the time is taken as in second. Like for example, this particular threaded sleep, it is taken by default as millisecond. Here also in web explicit wait, the time is taken as second by default. Okay, you need not to define as implicit wait in which unit of time it will be taking it. Okay, so what I did is I'll be using a function until where I passed a expected condition dot presence of element located, and I'll be giving the by dot xpath or by dot name of that particular web element. Okay, so now what this particular piece of code will do, it will wait for this particular password text area web element. So implicit wait is for the whole page and explicit wait is for the particular web element. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let's say for example, what is happening here is when I am hitting a URL, once I write this piece of code to navigate to this URL, so what here it is happening, it is hitting its server and it is getting out a response from it. Okay, it is doing a API call in the backend. In UI, you are seeing this particular UI is getting opened, but in backend there is a API hit going on. So we are sending a request and we are getting a response. If that response get in a particular time frame, then we are able to open the link. Else you can see a particular error will be written, like the server is down or the application is not responding because it exceed that response time. Let's say for example, the default response time is 10 seconds. So if it that exceed that 10 second, and if my response from the server comes at 11 second also, it will show me either in the browser that the server is not responding, even if the server is up and running. Okay, so every browser has a default time period in which it is expecting to get the response from the server. So here, let's say for example, my default time period for getting out the response from the server is 10 second, but my response is coming in 15 seconds. So even if my server is up and running, I am not able to execute my script and it's showing that the server is down and the application is not opening. So what I can do is I can increase that response time through my code. Okay, that is also dynamic, similar to implicit and explicit timer. Once the response time, I increase the response time, like say for example, my default response time is 10 second and I increase the response time to 20 second and my response came in 15 seconds. So after 15 second, the next line of code will be getting executed. That 5 second will not be getting wasted. So for that, I'll be using page load timeout wait. That particular wait will I'll be using just before the line of code where I am hitting the URL. Okay, and this will be used only one time because I'll hit the URL only one time. If there is another area in the script execution where you are hitting a server, there also you can use this particular web element if you want to increase the server response time. Okay, is similar. Now see, it's just similar to implicit wait, only difference it we are using page load timeout, and similarly we are passing the argument and that unit of time which we want to pass it as. Okay, Got my point?
Yes, sir.
So this is the pretty much way in which I can synchronize my code to increase the code speed so that my script execution will not get failed because of the mismatch of the application speed and code execution speed. Okay. Hello?
Yes, sir.
So we are achieving it by majorly by four weight. One is normal weight threaded sleep, which is advisable not to use unless it's that's necessary, because it will be wasting my time even if my web element and page gets loaded. So it is always advisable to use dynamic weight rather than this threaded sleep weight, which is implicit weight, explicit weight, and page load timeout weight. So page load timeout weight is for increasing the server response time. Implicit weight is for like it waits for the whole web page to load. Explicit weight is only for a particular web element to get loaded in a particular time. Got my point? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.